Welcome back from the break. You're right here with us on the ground, about more than 500 meters away from Super Tech Towers. You can see them right now on your screens. These towers, as you already know, set to be demolished at 2:30 p.m. And when they get demolished, they will be the tallest buildings ever to be demolished in our country. Also, one of the tallest ever to be demolished across the world. This is at least what the contractors involved in the entire process have to say. On the top of your building, you can see Edifice Engineering from Mumbai is going to be doing it. Right underneath Edifice Engineering, you can also possibly see the name tag and slogan for Jet Demolishing from South Africa. They're working with the company in Mumbai. Both companies are coming together to coordinate this effort. Now, I have colleagues across Noida station bringing you coverage on the story right now. My colleague Akash with us first. Let's go over to him right now to understand more. Akash, for our audiences, can you summarize what the effort has looked like for those residents who live in the areas around Supertech? What has their legal battle looked like over the last few years?
Right, so Toya, so these two towers are basically part of Supertech Emerald's court only. Right. And we were told initially, while we had a word with some of the residents, so we were told that because of these two buildings, they were unable to get sunlight. They were unable to get, you know, all the things that were required at that particular place. In fact, they were expecting a park to be built there. But instead, the builder, you know, constructed this tall tower, these tall buildings. So that's the reason why just a few minutes back I was talking about the legal battle, which got started in 2012, straight from Allahabad High Court to Supreme Court, where Supreme Court finally gave order to demolish this particular building. And today, finally, today is the time when we are going to see this particular exercise. In fact, in 2 hours from now, from 2 p.m., we'll be seeing a whole lot of activities. In fact, you know, Noida to Greater Noida, the expressway will be closed. You know, traffic would be diverted. Also, police will be, you know, seen roaming in the area, will be seen patrolling. Also, we are expecting some sort of announcements at that time, because an advisory was issued earlier saying that people are advised to stay, remain in their houses and not to come out at their rooftop because of the dust that is expected after the demolition. And also, 1 minute before the particular time, 2:30, we are expecting a siren, a sound of siren, which is expected, which will be a final call to that particular blast. Also, you know, day before yesterday, I had a word with Chetan Datta, who is going to press the button. He's an Indian certified blaster, and he was very excited. He was very excited about this particular event because he was very happy seeing that, you know, residents of this particular society have won the battle. It was a legal battle for almost a decade. You know, they got this particular matter started in 2012, and finally, after, you know, after 10 years in 2022, they are getting this justice that these illegal towers are going to be demolished. 2:30 is the time period, and we are waiting for it because, as you rightly mentioned in the starting, this is one of the mega demolition in India and one of its kind of event here in Delhi NCR. We see normal, you know, demolition processes in Delhi and in Noida, Faridabad and Gurugram as well. But this is one of its kind and is going to be very, very important in terms of messaging as well, Toya.
All right, the buildings you can see behind me, I'd just like to point out to you, as we speak, 9,000 holes have actually been drilled in the bottom of these two buildings over the last few days. And the 3,000 plus kgs of explosives that we keep talking about, almost 4,000 kgs, they've been put into those holes. This is a controlled implosion, which means that the building itself will implode into itself. It's deliberately been structured so that when the implosion happens, it will be controlled. Even then, as you already know, all precautions have been taken. Now, I have colleagues